And so what is interesting about, like we talked about some of the kind of beware moments of this, the COVID crisis kind of in the representation of Jesus, but this could actually be a humongous opportunity for people. And one of the things that I was thinking through is the reason that the internet is so attractive to our culture, there's a piece of it that is we are more comfortable with that medium than we are in a person-to-person interaction.
Yeah.
And I was just thinking, like, man, what an opportunity that we have now to like send a message to somebody or to like just post an encouraging word to somebody in their feed or in their inbox or whatever, email, whatever you need, and just say like, hey, I've been thinking about, I know you don't really know what I believe, but I just want to let you know that I'm praying for you.
Yeah.
And there's like this anonymity that we love to post, you know, really negative things on Twitter or whatever. And we kind of hide behind our screen name. But there's also this opportunity to that,
right,
to where, man, if I'm terrified to actually like walk up to somebody at the supermarket and be like, you should think about Jesus, you know,
right,
that I could actually have a meaningful interaction with somebody right now on the internet that could spur on further conversation.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think it's good for you to always, but man, if you're just dipping your toes in the water in this disciple making thing, what better time than now?
Yeah.
To just be like, hey, I've been praying for you and your family.
Yeah.
You know, and that might start the ball rolling in a lot of different ways. And especially for people who don't have the hope of heaven.
Right.
Like this could be incredibly nerve-wracking for people who don't, you know, the ending is happy for every Christian, right? Mm-hmm. You know, like we
hope, sir.
Cuts in line to heaven, and you know, even if you get there poor, you just get more crowns, right? That's what I'm hoping for. That's what I keep telling my wife. If we're, the poorer we are, the more treasure in heaven we've stored up. So I don't think she buys it. So
That's really good. That's really good, Eric. And I'm even sitting here thinking, and like I'll even look at you and say it. We're doing this stuff because, you know, we feel called to do it. We feel responsible to do it. But I'm also thinking when I'm doing this stuff, I'm literally thinking about friends and family that are on my social media who don't know Jesus. And I'll be honest, my hope is that,
yeah,
is that you come across this. And if you've listened up to this point, I'm impressed. Like if you're a not Christian person who follows Jesus or doesn't really know about that yet, and you've listened up until this point, like this is actually for you. I'm motivated to do this for you because this is a safe and comfortable way for you to like see, you know, really what this whole thing's about and hear about it in a safe environment and an anonymous environment. Yeah. And my hope is that these kinds of things actually spur you on and encourage you and actually make you ask questions that you weren't thinking about before, or at least make a little bit more accessible to you. Because, you know, most of the time people are afraid because it's unknown and it's not accessible because it's unknown, right? Like I wouldn't just show up and walk into a mosque, you know, on a Friday for prayers, right? I would never do that because I just don't know. I don't know if I'm allowed to.
Right?
I don't know what to do. I don't know what's going to happen, right? Yeah. You know what I mean? Like I don't know. Yeah. I'm not a part of it. Am I even allowed to do that? You can tell me if I'm allowed. I don't know. But we're here saying like that.
It's no different. Like what we do.
You may feel the same way about me. You may feel the same way about showing up to the movie theater on Sunday morning in Milton. Yeah. And I'm here saying like, you've gotten this far. You're looking at me. I'm saying like, you're allowed to, you're wanted to, like actually what we do
ask
on Sunday
question
is set up for people who aren't a part of it. It's not an insider. It's actually an outsider thing. And like, you can feel that freedom and that safety to start that conversation, engage that conversation, or show up or be a part of like the community thing we're doing or whatever. Like, it's just, it's really me, the me, you know. And this kind of stuff that we're talking about, faith, Jesus, church, community is for you. It's accessible to you, right?
Yeah. No, I agree.
So for people to have that same perspective of this unique opportunity, I think is healthy.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the whole thing.
Sometimes people are turned off because like the church is pretty explicitly like we don't have ulterior motives.
No.
We have a very specific motive, which is I'm convinced that Jesus is the answer. And I'm trying to convince you that Jesus is the answer. That's, you know, but that comes across as kind of strange to people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think that's why, like, if I'm not the person you were describing, if I'm like a Christian, like sometimes that feels very like pushy almost. You know what I mean? But I think the reality is that we can be honest about, you know, what it is that we're doing here. And the reason that we can be honest is because we're convinced that it's true.
Yeah.
If it wasn't true, I wouldn't be trying to convince you that it was. Or if I didn't believe, right? You know what I mean?
Or if you have like, if you have a better idea. Like I'm open to it. I've explored them. I want more of them. Right? There's nothing to hide here, right? It's not like, you know, sometimes people associate churches with like new religious movements or cults or other religions that are kind of closed. And you know, even like social groups like the Masons who like, you don't really know anything. You know, you can get in at level three, and then anything above, you don't know anything about until you're there, kind of thing. Like, that's not at all with the church. That is not that.
You can ask your question.
It's sort of like here's the thing we're all reading. It's in your language. Here's all the tools to read it. Just go and read it and talk to us. You know what I mean? It's like totally open.
Yeah, I think that's interesting.